Computers really only do two things: calculate stuff and make decisions about the things they calculate. Everything a computer does boils down to those two things. Even the most complex applications you can think of basically do some math and make a choice about what to do next. Do C or B or go back up to A again. Today, we're going to cover the first of these. The next few videos after this, we'll cover number two. Once you have those two things, you can technically make the machine do anything you want it to do. Everything we cover after that is just fancier, clever ways to organize solutions. Last video, we explored how variables are a way for a program to represent data. Specifically, we showed how we can store integers, whole numbers, in an int variable, and have the program print whatever value is currently stored in it. Let's take a look at this meal prep program that I'm constructing. Our program prints out a meal with chicken, rice, and sweet potatoes. And we wanted to track the total calories so we can get ripped. We looked up the calories online for each of these things, and obviously we could just pull up a calculator and add them together. But we can get C to do this for us. We'll replace our total with an expression that calculates the same thing using the add operator. When we run the program, it first declares our total calories variable. Then, on our assignment line, it needs to calculate the result of our expression to figure out what to assign to total calories. It adds all of the numbers together to get a total of 430. That total of 430 is then what is assigned to our total calories variable. That means when it gets to this printf statement, it prints out total calories 430, because that's what the current value of the total calories variable is. Whenever you see a number, we can also swap it out for a variable instead. Maybe we want to prep a few different meals with chicken. It's an option to just repeat the 200 calories for chicken in each of these calculations, but it would be a pain if we needed to change them later. Plus, it's easy to forget which number is which. So we'll make a new variable called chicken calories with the same value, and then swap out our literal values with the variable instead. When the program runs, we'll declare our chicken calories variable and set its value. Then declare our total calories variable. The adding works pretty much the same as before, but with the extra step of looking up what value is stored in the chicken variable and using that when adding everything together. And the same for our second meal. It also pulls the same chicken variable into its calorie calculation. In fact, it's usually a good idea to name most of your values with variables. That way you can remember what each is without needing to write a comment. Plus, you might notice that now our calculations make a lot more sense when you read them aloud. It's easy to see that this one is chicken plus rice plus sweet potatoes, and this one is chicken plus quinoa and avocado. When they were numbers, you'd have to take the time to decipher what's going on. So that's the add operation. In basic math, we use these four operations, and you can use them in C code too. But they look a little different. Specifically, the multiplication is represented by an asterisk and division by a forward slash. Here's a program that uses subtraction to help me estimate how old members of my family are, because I'm bad at remembering. We store the current year in a variable, and then, like before, we calculate the value of our other variables. Just now, we're subtracting instead of adding. And we print out the results. You may have also noticed that I declared and assigned the value in one line. In all of the programs we've looked at so far, we did this as two separate steps, because I wanted to illustrate that declaration and assignments are really two different things. But for conciseness, most people always do it at the same time. For multiplication, we have this program which gives you a pancake recipe, starting with the ingredients. We multiply each of our ingredient quantities by this scale variable. That way, if you want to make double the amount of pancakes, you can change the scale variable to 2. Our updated program will now print out double the amount of the ingredients. Division with integers works slightly differently than you'd expect. Since integers are whole numbers, integer division will result in a whole number. If you remember long division from elementary school, you'd find both the result, the quotient, and the remainder, which is the amount left over after dividing. This is how division works here. Personally, I just find it easier to think about it as dividing the number and then dropping everything after the decimal. So in this example, we have 12 donuts and we have 5 coworkers trying to split them. So we divide the donuts by the number of coworkers and the program prints out 2 donuts each, which makes sense because everyone can get 2 whole donuts from the box and it'll be fair. And then there's 2 donuts left over in the box, destined to be forever unloved because knives haven't been invented yet. C can also tell you the remainder by using another operator called the modulus operator, which is represented by a percentage sign. Running this program tells us both that each person gets 2 donuts, and there's 2 left in the box. Okay, let's combine everything we've talked about into a larger example. We're working on renovating our house, and right now we're looking at reflooring all of our rooms. We've measured the various square footage of each room we want to retile. Not every room will be using the same tile, though, and with our budget, we're trying to see what we can afford. Here's the price per square foot for a few types we're considering. We're thinking that the living room, bedroom, and basement will all be done in hardwood. So we'll add all of those together to get their combined square footage, then multiply that result against the cost of the walnut flooring. Notice the brackets here. They ensure that the addition happens before the multiplication. By default, C follows the standard order of operations. So if we didn't have them, it would actually do this multiplication first, then add all of the other numbers together, which isn't right. We force the addition to go first by placing those parentheses around it. Then the multiplication happens after. For the 2 bedrooms, we're just going to go with some cheap ceramic tile, so that way we can go for something fancy in the kitchen, which we want to do in marble. Now we just want to total all of the prices up. At the end, we just print out our total, which is too rich for us. So we'll swap out our marble for vinyl. Okay, that's a bit more manageable. Now we can have code that does work for us. When the iPhone's App Store first came out, it pretty much just had flashlights and calculators. So now we could do our part and build some calculators and party like it's 2008. On CodeAesthetic.io, I ask you to build some calculators and use them to calculate the secret answers for some aesthetic points.